Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, or one lady, others seems all to be gentlemen. Hello, Raleigh, Etienne, Fanny, Luan. Nice to see you all here. And tonight, it's an open ball. Let's see what you can see. Let's see what you can ask. Let's see what you can tell me. What's happening in the markets? Shiva, can I get your mics on? Why don't your mics come on? Luan, I saw your hand. Why can't I get your mics on? I'm going to put your mics on. Okay, not to worry. There is Luan's mics is on. Yes, hi Luan. Please put your mics on your side, please, that you can talk to me. We're just a few, we're just five. So let's make it an open discussion. What I want to show you, I can start off with the JSE All Share. Take this away. Then we will see that the JSE All Share is really, as we spoke about earlier, since we get a line there, cross here, there, when was that? 25 January 2018. We start this slide. Okay. We try to make footing on this level of 54.880. And it's now coming under pressure. Okay, so just look here. We try to cross this barrier again on the 5th of August, the 6th of August, all the way down until the last time that we tried is the 18th. Today, we went below the trend line. Okay, so the markets are going down. If you look at the RSI at the bottom, RSI is up, but you can draw a line here. Also in a negative tendency, past the 50 line. Remember, above 50, it's bullish. Below 50, it's bearish. Then let's get overbought at 17 or oversold at 30. Now this is particularly true with stocks, and also the similarities are pretty much equal on the All Share. Okay, so this is the All Share. Now I want to, let me see, funny, your benefit, I'm going to go first, I'm going to go to Sasol. I don't know if you still have Sasol. If you have Sasol, Sasol really scared everybody. Just want to get some perspective here. Now, Fanny bought Sasol way back here somewhere. Okay, but now it's a very negative thing, but the beauty is with that, if you buy with shares, not CFDs or futures, where it's a geared instrument and you might gobble up all your deposit or your collateral lying in your account. With shares, it's not that big a deal because companies like Sasol will bounce back. Like they say with Eskom, too big to fail. Well, I see them failing all the time, but yeah. Suppose Sasol is a different story. Look at Sasol. I got these downtrend lines. Sasol went and it touched base with this level that you had here on the 123.23. Huge. Almost a doji or spinning negative spinning top. Tomorrow, the opening, it seems like it wants to turn the clock around. Okay, so there's the down one. There's the other one. It seems like it wants to reverse. So possibly there's some upside coming here. It also seen that it's very much oversold at the moment on the other side. So I think Sasolbaum might do good. And not just fall through there into the abyss, because if it breaks this line, there's another level, and then it's all the way down, and there's nothing. There's the Fibonacci level, 38.2% level. If you look at the Fibonacci, I'll draw the Fibonacci from this high there. That high there is being 100% because we sort of in an uptrend. And then this low here, the bottom, has the 0%. Okay, so this is the Fibonacci, they are all the Fibonacci levels, and also the forecast where it's supposed to find support in its way up. Okay, but what we really would like to see is a crossing of the 200-day moving average. Okay, that's somewhere in the future. It's not happening now. But yes, I would think, my view of Sasol, it is okay. It should be okay. It ran away from this with 3.52 million shares today. So it touched base here. There's a huge buyback. Not enough to take it above this previous support level, but almost. Okay, so it has tested this level many times before. This is a strong base, and it seems like it is looking to turn around. Okay, so that's Sasol. Now, I want you to tell me which shares would you like to guys like to look at. Juan, you seem to have the only one with a mic.
I'm still very much, evening, hello. I'm still very much into this thing.
So, I can't hear you. Say that again.
I said evening. I'm still very much new to this, so I'm all in a learning curve at this point.
Okay, which one are you looking at, Juan?
Anyone really. Like I said, I'm still very much new to this, so I'm still trying to find my feet around everything.
Okay, finding your feet is not that difficult, but yes, you gotta see what the share tells you. What is it busy doing at the moment? Okay, so Raleigh, Etienne, I want to ask you, what shares are you struggling with? Luan, give me a chat there, tell me. Otherwise, I'm just going to steamroller through a lot of shares. And then Etienne got a question mark. Etienne, what does it mean? If you have microphones, I can put them on the set, but it doesn't work. Okay, so meaningless to say, there's a question. Yes. Let's look at Exaro and click Raleigh, thank you. With pleasure. I'll look at how many now as well. Okay, just give me a second. We'll look at Exaro and clicks. Exaro. Now, this is very much in the coal business, né? Very much in the coal business. Now, perhaps you should start looking at the monthly chart. Because of the monthly chart, you can really see the levels. Or you can, let's do that. Let's go to there. Let's go to the Fibonacci. Then go to settings, tick all the boxes so that you can get all these levels. And then we say we want to look at the Fibonacci from this. Well, let's take that as this is then the 100 there. We're going there, we're going uptrend. There, we're going down to this one, to this leg. Okay, so there we are. We're really trying to break the 61% barrier. Almost, well, depending on where it opens tomorrow, that can really fix this as a base. Look at a trend line. Take a trend line from this bugger. And there's a base there. There was one there. Let's use the last one. Okay, so tomorrow, this is the vertical for today. This is the vertical for tomorrow. It's almost below the line. If it moves below the line, that line becomes a resistance. So if it's just above the line, depending when it opens tomorrow, it still can render support. If it renders support, then obviously there's also some blocks there. Let me take that and we'll make that a red line. You'll see that there in the middle of this, So it's there, no? There's another level there. There's another level there. Strong resistance there. Strong resistance. Opening point, opening price, closing price. So there's a strong resistance. So if it opens here tomorrow on this level above this trend line, it might go there. This becoming overbought, but that's not to say it cannot go there. It can go easily there. Let's see what it does today, tomorrow. 11.8 million shares also traded today. Lots of 17.1 million. Lots of shares, 34 million shares trading. And so really there seems to be many, many players in the field. Okay, so that's the level. It might go there tomorrow. Let's see what it does. This is the closing. It tried, it pulled back some more, somewhat from that level, but that's not much. It opens here tomorrow. To market there, it might go there. But most probably, it just might go there. Everything is positive. Lots of shares trading, and that's what's my viewpoint for XAR. Let's look at it tomorrow. I'll take a note and I'll put it on Telegram. Just for your interest sake, for those of you that's on Telegram, by the request, we put some shares of Anglo and DRD and Harmony and there's Sasol. When I looked at Sasol this morning, I said, want to touch this level again. So he did touch the level and he's trying to pull back. But go to our Telegram web, we'll keep that Telegram alive. Now let's look at Clicks. Clicks, what a beauty. What a beauty. Look at this shit. There's no end to it. Always make sure that you got this lock scale on, otherwise it is shit. The chart becomes cockeye. Take your pick. Where do we start? Look at this level here. Look at this low. Look at this low. This is on the monthly chart there. What a beauty. Way past, there's no, it's never been here. Open skies. Now, what you look at the share on the monthly scale, let's do it there. There's a base. There's a base. Now here somewhere there seems to be some form of resistance. There seems to be some form of resistance. Let's change this color. There's the strength. There's the strength. Tomorrow opening very close today. Beautiful. Put that level, that line under pressure. Beautiful. There was a signal. There was a bicycle. Why was there a bicycle? There's the down. Downer, there was a bicycle, there was the breakout. There was the breakout today. That was the breakout. Okay, so opening day today, don't put pressure on that line. It might not go through it, but yes. Let's go down to the daily chart. The daily chart, it looks almost cocky now. But yeah, there was the breakout for the monthly. Now there's the levels that we spoke about earlier. There's a level there. I think the level is there. The level is definitely there. Okay, so there's the level. Needs to go through that level. There was a strong pullback this afternoon. How come can I not know? I don't know why there was such a big pullback, but there's the space as well. There's the space. Always see if you can determine there's daily levels, monthly levels, weekly levels. On the monthly levels, those are the stronger levels. But on the daily basis, if it can remain on this level, it should be okay if you take a line there and just on a intersect, do that. And tomorrow we would like to see it open here, open above. Seems like there's a downside here. Perhaps it can move sideways on this level. Just move sideways, getting some, build some steam up to tackle that level again. Okay, so perhaps there's just a small consolidation happening here because this says there's some downside here. But as long as it maintains this level, it will be okay. If it breaks this level, of course, then there's all the next stops. All the next stop. Just see where you can connect the most dots. That's where the levels are. If you don't know where the levels are, feel free to use a Fibonacci. Put the Fibonacci on, it'll give you the levels. Let's do it. If you want me to do it, let's go there. Fibonacci. Now, the previous high is this line. So we're ultimately going there. Let's say we come from here. Then these are the levels. But one gets easily confused when there's so much lines, so many lines on the block. Don't keep it simple. Keep it simple. I think it'll just go sideways on this first. Then it's far away from this bottom. And also what is important is that this is rather a midway stop. Yeah. From that high to this low, there's a midway stop. It's also that lever. Oh, come on now, I've got the Fibonacci, that's wrong. You take a line, see that midway stop is there. That midway stop is there. Okay, but for argument's sake, it will go sideways in this block until it can build up momentum. It will go upside again because everything is just going up. Look at this shed. It's a beautiful shed. It looks on the monthly scale. Look at it on the monthly scale. What a pleasure. What a pleasure. Look at all the buy signals here. You've got high and you've got lower highs. You got the buy signals. There's the buy signals coming out, bouncing on a 20-day moving average. There, with all these monthly buy signals there. There are the signals there. Previous resistance is always the next support base. Yeah. So I think this shield just might just drift sideways. It's going to give that. That I go there again soon. It looks, look how much data here is on the daily chart. Ish. But yeah, there we are again. It's going to put pressure, it's going to consolidate, make a turnaround, come back, and have another go at that. Because look here, it's normally it's a pole of flag. You're busy with the third leg here. Okay, then it'll go up. So that's beautiful. That's the beauty of that. Let's look at the other question. Let's look at, I can't remember now which was other questions. Just give me that question again. Which share are we looking at? I lost that question. Here you are. Look at Harmony. Let's look at Harmony. I've got Harmony on my block. Telegram as well. Look at Harmony. Let's take this away. There you go, Harmony. It's really in a down spiral because of the gold price. If Harmony cannot maintain this level tomorrow, it'll break negative and it'll go down to this level. that's the next stop. We stop there, stop there, stop there tomorrow. Of course, the gold price has also come down slightly. So Harmony is definitely going back here tomorrow. It opens, depending where it opens, if it opens there, scenarios might change, but if I take that as a vested high, take that as a vested high, depending where it opens tomorrow. That's today's vertical, that's tomorrow's vertical. If it opens on this line, it can find support on this line, can find support on the stop side. But yeah, I think Harmony is rather in a consolidating phase between these two levels. That one, 108.88, and this one, 98.26. It's sort of consolidating, waiting for the gold price to do what it's supposed to do, and then it'll follow suit, follow along with it. Because so that's Harmony. Thank you. Etienne, are you happy with Harmony? I'll put Harmony on Telegram as well. Go look there. Feel free to go look at Telegram. Okay, another share that we can just spot at. Look at Woolies. Woolies, that's a long, long negative trend. That line is not properly there. It is pretty there. Make it bigger because I'm losing my lines because they're all over the show. Let's go back with that line. So I cannot really work with outlines. So I'm going to use those two tops there. That top, this top gives me a base, and the spinning top. The spinning top is where it's in the center of gravity between the two poles. And if it's a green, it's a bullish spinning top. So meaning that we can see some upside tomorrow. If you take those three, there you go. There's the trend. And you can even extend it. You can extend it right down to there. There's the bottom trend. There's the baseline. It's the breakthrough that level. Don't buy it below the level, please. Never ever buy anything below a line. Wait for it to break the line. You need the share to close above the line, open above the line. Then you can go with it. Then you put your stop loss in previous levels just below the line there. Put your stop loss in there. That's where you buy it. You buy it when it bounces here, you put your stop loss there. If it doesn't go through, it comes back, you lose your costs plus some small change. It's not that big a deal. But if you buy it at the top, at the end of a trend, we're starting with a new trend. Now look, we got a pole, you got a flag, you got a pole. This is the second leg. That's not really a leg, that. This is, I would say, this is it's going to do the second leg here. Okay, but it needs to break these levels. It needs to close and open above this level. Then you say, okay, let's go with it. There's the bicycle. The bicycle is there. It's imminent. And also, let's leave it like this. There's enough breakout on this line. Okay, so this is Woolies. Woolies is ultimately wanting to go back to the 200 moving average. There's that level. It's all about levels and trends. There's the 200. If it catches up with the 200, we can start out a bullish tendency again with bullish. Is somebody going to ask the questions? Ethan, Harmony, Exaro. Now, Exaro is, of course, coal, eh? place with a lot of coal. Anyone who will buy it, we can export it to them. Let's look at ShopRite. ShopRite, we had some levels here. Beautiful. We had some levels here, which it broke. Beautiful, broke it flat out. Came back and tested. Don't buy something which runs away. You're waiting it for cross the barrier to close and bounce. Close and bounce. Come back and bounce, and there was the buy signal. Not really move that candle around anymore. But there was a downside. There's the buy signal. It's negative today, strong negative today, but it's still above this level. Can maintain this level, it should be okay. But seems like it also wants to consolidate. Perhaps if it comes down, it can even come down and consolidate down further. There, perhaps. This is just all speculation. I'm just putting these lines up at random. There's no science to it. Okay, but there's the level. If it breaks this level, perhaps it can find support on this previous level. There's why we've got a closing price. We've got a low there. We've got some other prices there. So there's definitely a base there. But if it doesn't, it'll come back down to this level. Okay, so what's happening with ShopRite? Just go have a look and see what's happening in the market. What news is there? What's happening there? I don't know, gender violence, which has got to do with ShopRite, but these are the market news. Okay, so this is ShopRite. So they're not doing that good, given the but they were not doing good since long time, not since the pandemic. They're not doing good long before that. Look at this negative trend. Negative trend from long ago. But yeah, there's the breakout. We had a nice breakout here. And now we're trying to recoup and focus forward. Go back to the daily chart. There's the more details here. Oh, that's better. Ladies. Gentlemen, thank you, Raleigh. You must come and give us class now, because you've been at every lecture all over the show. Please, I want to invite you, put your microphone in place, come talk to us next time. If it's Afrikaans 6 session, if it's Monday morning, join our class. Let's give us some pointers there. Okay, please, let's make this something that we can all have a share in, all of our say, all of our input, because none of us knows everything, but all of us knows a lot. Okay, so we put our heads together, we can really come up with some smart ideas. Let's look at resources. We looked at resources dependent on, let's look at the financials. I see Moxie is looking at financials now. First Rand, Standard Bank, there was levels here, very much sideways. A long, big, fat can was not going anywhere. There was a huge breakout here today. Standard Bank, huge breakout here today. 3.97 million shares. Boost this. I see our rand is strengthening again against the dollar, or the dollar is weakening. Needless to say, it doesn't matter which way, as long as we benefit. If our rand strengthened or the dollar weakens, our financials will do good. They will be in a better position. Okay, if that can be a continuous. Sondam, there's also. Look at this one. I was going to put the label there. Welcome to put it where you want. I would like to put the label there. So it almost broke it. There's a trend. Starting to with a massive trend here. So there's a trend. It's still got ample space to come to grips with this level and break it to the top. So this is the former Absa Bank, more amalgamated banks. The mutual really caught in a box there. You want to do that? Let's do it. There you go. In the box, it's not really good. It fell out here, it came back into the box. So you need a breakout. You need to close above the line, open above the line. There's some levels there as well. Not really that strong, but there's also levels there. But you need it to break out the box before it can go anywhere. Let's look at. There's also, this seems to go nicely, Remgro. Let's take a segment there. There's a low, there's a high there. That was definitely a bicycle there tomorrow, this morning. Beautiful bicycle there. Right out there, beautiful. Now, it went through that level. It's really. Here at this level, it seems to have closed above it already. Okay, so there's Remgro. Pulled back strongly this afternoon, but if it opens above this line tomorrow, there's ample space for it to go further to that next level there. Or look to see where we can connect the most dots. And it's almost easy when you have previous levels that has been established on the downside. Because on the downside or the upside, the levels, the price levels where the market decides that this is a good price for the share at this particular point in time, it's still always a good level. So there's Remgro. If it opens here tomorrow, it must probably just go straight there. There's a 20-day moving average rendering support, beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, we went over time some, but not to worry. Nice talking to you. Please join us Monday at 1 o'clock. Give me your viewpoints if we should do it earlier on Mondays, when them after the market opened, so that we can have an early entrance or early peep at what the market is doing after the rollover. From Friday to Monday. Okay, thank you very much. Have a nice evening. Goodbye.